Hello! My name is Robin. I work for the RSPB, the Royal Society Protection of Birds. We are a nature conservation charity that helps protect nature for people and wildlife to enjoy. Today, I'll be delivering you a session called Sources and Solutions to Pollution, and we'll be looking at the Sources and Solutions to Pollution in the River Forth. Your learning outcome for today is learning about the sources of and solutions to pollution through experiment, games, and artwork. To begin with, I'll explain what pollution is and what pollutants we find in the River Forth, and we'll talk about the negative effects this has on the water and wildlife. You will then do an interactive pollution experiment as a class to help understand the effects of pollution has on the environment. And then we'll join back together and learn all the different ways that we can take action to reduce pollution in our river. To finish, I'll set you an RSPB wild challenge. But first, Makaton. Makaton uses our words, symbols, and signs and gives extra visual clues to help with our general understanding and basic communication. The word we're going to learn today is to do. We can see the picture, which is the symbol of the two hands, one on top of each other, and the sign, which is the action, which we'll do together. For the sign to do, we want to make two fists and put your dominant hand, so the hand that you use most, on top of the other. As we say the word to do, we want to take the top hand and bang it off the bottom one and give it a little scoop like that. To do. To do. Let's try that together. To do. Great job. Now, every time I say to do, throughout today's session, I want you to join in with a Makaton with me. What is pollution? Pollution is harmful substances such as gases, smoke, waste, or chemicals that enter and contaminate the environment, which can cause animals harm and plants harm and humans health harm. Some forms of pollution can be seen, whereas others are invisible. There are three main forms of pollution. It can happen in the air, in the water, or on the land. Today, we'll be concentrating on pollution which ends up in the water. The Inner Forth is home to many different types of habitats, such as woodlands, grasslands, wetlands, moorlands, mudflats, and rivers. They're all really important for wildlife, as this is where they access their food, water, and shelter. It's their homes. We need to protect them and not pollute them. Pollution comes from human activity, and in places such as farmlands, industrial and urban. The natural habitats are really important to protect. The types of pollution that we're going to be looking at today, which can be found in the River Forth, unfortunately, is fertilizers, pesticides, oil, ash, and plastic. Fertilizer. Why do we use it? We add it to the crops grown in the fields to give it extra nutrients it needs for the crops to grow and produce an abundant harvest. But what problems can it cause? Sometimes the nutrients in the fertilizer are not the correct one, or too much is added. This means that the soil and the plants can't absorb all of the fertilizer. So, if the crops and soil can't absorb the fertilizer, it remains on top of the soil and can be washed off into the rivers by the rain where it does not belong and can have a negative impact on the environment. Pesticides. Why do we use them? We use pesticides to kill pests of crops so that we can grow more crops. Pests can damage crops and ruin a harvest, so we need to control them. They might be a swarm of locusts that come in, or some aphids, sap-sucking insects. So what's the problem with using pesticides? Pesticides can harm and kill other animals or pests that are useful for the food chain. They can be washed off into the river by rain where it does not belong and can have a negative impact on the life in the water. Let's take a closer look to see how pesticides can impact a food chain. All living things need food to be able to survive. Food chains are one way to demonstrate how energy is transferred between plants and animals. Each is dependent on the next as a source of food. We usually start with the producers, in this case, honeysuckle, which then moves on to the aphids, which are seen as pests. These now become the prey of the ladybirds, which are the predator. But then further up, the ladybirds become the prey of the predator thrushes. But what happens if we use pesticides to kill the aphids? This means the ladybirds wouldn't have any food to eat, so then they'll no longer survive, which then means the thrushes have no food to eat, which means they'll no longer survive. That is why every part of the food chain is important. Now we have seen how pesticides impact the food chain if pests are killed. Let's have a think about how fertiliser and pesticides can also affect the food chain. For example, if all this grass was sprayed with fertiliser and pesticides, that would mean if the rabbit ate the grass, they would also have fertiliser and pesticide inside them. And then what would that mean for the fox? That's right. Then the fox would eat the prey of the rabbit, who is eating the grass, meaning they all now have fertiliser and pesticides inside the belly, which cannot be very good for them and make them very ill. Also, if fertiliser and pesticides end up in the water, the aquatic animals can eat them and absorb it, or also they create algae blooms. This can stop light getting into the water and absorb extra oxygen. Animals at the bottom of the water can die without light and oxygen. Oil. Why do we use it? Oil is a fossil fuel, which has served us extremely well in the past. We have used it for fuel to run cars, planes, boats, and to make things such as traffic cones, plastic, rubber boots, clothes, and detergents. It's very useful and has helped develop our local and global society massively. Grangemouth is now the only oil refinery left in Scotland. But what problems can be caused by oil? Oil unfortunately causes climate change on land, and also in oceans, oil spills can happen and remain on the surface of water for a very long time. Oil is lighter than water and does not decompose, and is toxic to all the animals in the sea and flying above it. The oil can stick and mat the feathers of birds, which makes it difficult for them to fly, difficult for them to float, and be less insulated, which means they get really cold and poorly easily. Cleaning birds is a specialist job. So the SSPCA take control of that. ASH. Why do we use it? ASH was given out by coal-powered industries during the Industrial Revolution and deposited to reclaim land. Unfortunately, coal is another fossil fuel which is contributing towards the climate crisis. But what problems can be caused by the ash? When the ash was deposited to reclaim land, more industry, intensive farming, was built on it, which both are not very good for the environment, and also means there's a loss of habitat such as salt marsh and mudflats for wildlife. Reclaimed land is also very vulnerable to flooding or even sinking. Ash also ends up into the river. However, a power station deposited ash at Valleyfield Lagoons, which created a brilliant intertidal habitat for wildlife, or, as we can see in this picture, is RSPB Black Devon Wetlands Nature Reserve in Alloa. It was once a very industrial place in the past, but now a haven for wildlife. Once home to coal mines and a World War I airplane factory, the site was dug up to cap a nearby landfill site. This left behind pools and reed beds, which through careful management are providing a habitat for a number of bird species. This is a way that the ash was used positively. Plastics. Why do we use them? Plastic was invented in 1862 and is a useful, hard-wearing, lightweight material used for many things such as packaging, toys, and building materials. It's useful to protect and preserve things such as food and medicines, and some can be easily recycled. Unfortunately, although it wasn't invented that long ago, it has had a catastrophic effect on our environment. So what problems has plastic caused? 91% of plastics end up in landfill or the ocean, and it can take hundreds of years to break down. This causes harm to the environment and to the wildlife now and in the future. They can be single use and difficult to fix once broken. In the UK, 38.5 million plastic bottles are used every day. Near Kinneil Lagoons, there's a landfill site where all our rubbish goes. Littering is a big cause for plastic pollution. It can then get into our waterways, and animals get stuck in plastic bottles or different things of plastic and eat them, which can cause them harm or kill them. Therefore, plastic can sometimes even end up in our food chain as fishes eat the tiny microplastics and then we eat the fish. Look at all those plastic bottles which are going to waste. Now, it's time for the pollution experiment. As a class with your teacher, you will gradually add the different pollutants to your waterway and discuss what we have learnt and what you see to understand how these pollutants have affected the environment. Welcome back. Hope you had fun experimenting with all the different types of pollution in the river. And as we have learnt, this is not good for the wildlife or nature or for us. So, what can we do about this? Let's have a look at solutions to pollutions, how we can live in an environmentally responsible way to reduce pollution in the River Forth. solutions for fertiliser and pesticides. What can we do to reduce fertilisers and pesticides? We could buy local and seasonal, buy vegetable box from our local farms, eat food that uses less pesticides. Some supermarkets now sell cheap pesticide-free produce. Or we could grow our own veggies. This could be in a windowsill and something small like cress, or in a community or school garden and have a full veg patch filled with different vegetables such as carrots or beetroots. Solutions for oil. What can we do to reduce our oil? As we spoke about earlier, oil has served us very well in the past, but now that we're learning the negative impacts it has on our health and the environment, such as climate change and oil spills, we need to look at ways to reduce it. We can do this by walking and cycling and using public transport more, which means less driving and less fuel. We can use natural materials, as oil is found in beauty products such as perfume and different clothing materials which are synthetic. We could eat a more vegetarian based diet, as well as use local and seasonal foods, as this also uses much less oil. Also, reduce our plastic, so we might not need to use plastic bags and just reuse bags that we already have. Solutions for ash. What can we do to reduce our ash? As we spoke about earlier, coal has also served us very well in the past. It gave us energy for electricity and generated money for our local area, which is really important to know for our cultural heritage. However, now that we've learned about the negative impacts it can have on our health and the environment, we need to look at ways to reduce it. The UK has taken steps towards that, such as closing down our local organic station. We also need to look into alternatives from coal, such as renewable energy. This might be in the form of solar, wind, or tidal. You could, at home or in your school, switch to a green energy provider. Solutions to plastics. What can we do to reduce our plastic? Luckily, there's lots of alternatives and actions that we can take individually and collectively to reduce our plastic. We can reuse our water bottles, buy package-free foods, take our own carrier bags to the shops, reuse knives and forks instead of buying plastic ones, and same for straws. Upcycle and reuse any plastic that we do have before recycling it. Or we could do a litter pick and a beach clean or Nerdo hunt to prevent the plastic getting into the sea. And finally, I challenge you to get outside and complete an RSPB's Wild Challenge to experience and help nature. I challenge you to spread the word. It's time to use your voice to stand up for nature and share your learnings of the different actions from today to help protect the environment and reduce pollution. So, what are you going to do for nature? This activity is all about getting creative and building a case for nature that inspires others to take action and protect it. It might be in the form of a show, an art display, which you could use recycled materials for, a poster, you could attend a youth climate strike, or write a letter to your MP. Don't forget to ask your teacher to mark as complete, as this counts towards earning your badge. Good luck and well done for taking action to protect nature and wildlife. Goodbye!